There was time once when I took a machine to, actually I took two machines to this dressmaker shop, and I was hoping to sell her one. And anyway, it was a dressmaker whose work I really, really admired. And I was quite proud of the machines I had brought to her. And they were both domestic machines, they weren't industrials. And we got talking and everything, and she starts looking at the machines, and she got this look on her face where she was a little bit upset. I could tell she was upset with me, that basically I was wasting her time. And what she told me, she said, "Bob, you're a nice guy, but your work isn't good enough. Might be good enough for Susie Homemaker, but it's not good enough for professionals." And man, that kicked me in the teeth. I reeled back at that one. And I thanked her for her opinion. I was very polite. I thanked her for her opinion. And we had already packed the machine up, or the machines up. And I went on my way. And I had a long drive to get home, and I had a chance to think about what she had said. And there was a couple of things she had pointed out. It wasn't just simply, "Your stuff is lousy, get out of here." She backed it up. She pointed out a few things where it wasn't up to at least her standards. Now, I've since come to find that her standards were exceedingly high compared to a lot of other professionals that I know. But that's okay. Her standards were her standards, and that's what mattered, and I didn't meet them. But I thought about that long and hard for a long time, and I still think about it a lot. And what that afternoon at her studio did was made me up my game. So if you're wondering why I go through all the trouble of taking all of this stuff off, cleaning it to the nth degree, taking it out to the other shop and hitting it with the wire wheel and the flap sander and getting every bit of varnish off of it and getting it look to be absolutely perfect, like it as perfect as you can possibly make it, like it just came from the factory. That's where it comes from. Because never, ever, ever again am I going to have somebody whose work I admire say, "You're not good enough." Anyway, that's where it's all, that's what it came from, that's where it's about. This is not a customer machine, this is one of mine. But thanks for listening. See you on the next one.